We are very lucky, we are very happy that we can start this program with one of the most influential filmmakers, I may say, of the recent years. He's very young, so I'm not going to count years. But we are truly lucky to have you with us, Mr. Makhmalbaf, and I'm going to enjoy very much your talking to you on this high chair. So thank you for coming, and please join me.
I don't stream. You can sleep whenever you want.
You can start if you want. It's when it's Mr. Makhmalbaf's suggestion, I think we have to follow. He is the master. Yeah. Before we sleep, okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I want to start with getting to know Mohsen Makhmalbaf a little before delving into the cinema of Mohsen Makhmalbaf.
Yeah.
So what I know, which I find always very interesting, is that the beginning of your career, your relationship with cinema, is what you showed us in some of your films. In Silence, for example, is the fact that you truly did not watch a film before you were 22. Yes. You did not have the experience of watching a film until that late age, relatively. Can you tell us about life without cinema?
Actually, welcome. Thank you for coming here. I was born in a poor family in South Tehran, a religious family. And my father and my mother get married for 6 days. They made me and they left. My grandmother protect me. And under her hand, I heard that if we go to cinema, God put us in the hell. So in my childhood, I didn't go to cinema. And also while my grandmother was telling that if we hear music, God put us in the hell. So when I was a child in the street, I was putting my finger on my ear. And the worst thing, my grandmother was telling me that if you look at beautiful girl, God put you in the hell. So I was in the street. I love my grandmother. She was so kind, but she was so extremist in belief to dogmatism. So my childhood without cinema passed. Then we had dictator in Iran, like nowadays, the same. They are repeating themselves. In Iran, previous regime, we hadn't political party, we hadn't a free newspaper. If you read some political book, you should go 3 years in prison. And the country divided to two parts, completely poor and a little rich. So I was involved to politics from the age of 15, and I went to political prison in the age of 17. So around 4.5 years I was in political prison, so we didn't have chance to watch movie. In the age of 22, when happened revolution, I released from prison. And I was involved again with politics for a few months, but I understood very soon that my country has cultural problem. We recreate another dictatorship because of our culture. So I changed my position from politics and I came to cultural activity because I told we should change people's mind by another gun. So I started to write first, then I made film without any knowledge about cinema. I just started like Lumiere. like I want to make a film. I thought that camera could be like pen. If I can write, I can make film. And I learned cinema by making film. I made 3 films. Then I heard that this man doesn't know technique. But the first one was so successful. I started to read book. I borrowed books, I bought books. It was around 400 books about art, cinema, theater. And I learned cinema by myself. If I'm talking too much, you can cut me by for the rhythm.
When I cut you, you're talking too much. I will not cut you, absolutely. This is inspiring. And my question is, so out of the 400 books, what would be the book that you remember the most now?
Okay, the way that I read book still is important for me. I want to share with you. I call filing, because I start to read the book, the first book. I saw there are many different things in one book, for example, about the script writing, about acting, about lenses, about editing. I put a lot of paper with the title, like filing in computer. For example, I read first pages and I saw there is a one suggestion that it's better actor dialogue be the second job of actor. It's better you give him something to do than ask him to tell dialogue. So I wrote in the paper acting advice, one, blah, blah, blah. And in second page was talking about college of editing, for example. Okay, I put another page, editing, Koleshov. Koleshov says blah, 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 blah. Till the end of 400, anything was new. I was writing, but not in one notebook, in different paper. And it was very useful because at the end I had a lot of pages. But I tell you, I read 400 books, but actually they were 20 books. They repeat itself. They copying. They steal from each other. So we don't have 400 books about cinema, really. Okay, you can add another one. Read and add another one. But the experience of the cinema, I don't think it's 400 books. So very soon I understood I can read fast some part of others' book. But by dividing to different subject and summarizing, I understood that, okay, all those 400 books become for me 200 rules, but divided. For example, I want to go and find a good location. What is the rule of finding good location? Blah, blah, blah. I want to direct actor. What is the rule of directing actor? So I didn't confuse after that. When I made my next movie, they told, oh, genius man arrived in cinema. It was not genius. It was those rules which I learned. And I summarize. You know, I focus to read the book in a one time, 6 months. Not one book today, one book next month. So I observe and I didn't confuse. And so categorize and summarize and put in one small notebook in my pocket. My knowledge about cinema was a small notebook. Still, I am teaching those 200 rules like Alphabet of Cinema, which was the best university for me. I suggest you, anything that you read, if you categorize and summarize, is useful. If you don't categorize and not summarize, easily you will forget it and mix here, and brain doesn't have capacity to remember exactly what you want, because what is happening in our sleep, we sleep to let our brain organize the knowledge that we receive today. But if you categorize and you management the knowledge that you receive, okay, it's better, because otherwise by link, you are thinking about acting, you remember editing. You're thinking about editing, you remember writing. But if you categorize yourself, anything you need comes to your mind exactly in the moment that you need. It was my lesson After that, any magazine, any book which I receive and I read, I saw, oh, they are repeating. If it was something new, I could understand, because I already categorized that. So
I will, I think we can play one clip from Salam Cinema now, so that we develop the same point you were talking about. I think this is the right time for Salam Cinema.
اسمی شما چیه؟
سلام.
سلام.
آقای مخبوب شما هستی؟
من روبروتون هستم.
بله.
بله. سرتون رو لطفاً بالا بگیرید. اسم شما؟
هادی.
فامیلیتون؟
مختاریان.
از کجا اومدین؟
از کرمان. البته کرمانی نیستم.
کرمانی نیستی؟
بله.
الان کجا زندگی میکنی؟
کرمان.
عینکتون رو چرا زدی شما؟
جان؟
چرا عینک زدین؟
ایرادی داره؟
نه میگم دلیل خاصی داره؟
نه خب باشه بهتر نیست به نظرش.
بله بله. هر شبت که شما تا حالا بازی کردین؟
تئاتر با دوستم کار کردم. چند سالی است باش میرم. میام.
بله. الان تیکه چیزی حاضر کردین بازی کنین؟
بله اگه بخواید.
یه تیکه بازی کنیم برام.
همینجا.
همینجا.
چیزی اطرافم نیست؟
چیزی اطرافتون نیست ولی سعی کنید که یه قدم از هر طرف بیشتر عقب و جلو نرید چون از نور خارج میشید.
باشه چشم. حالا هر طور که باشه هر صحبتی.
بله یه تیکه بازی کنیم.
با اجازتون.
بله.
آری تمام زندگی من عشق من همین بود. توی این زندگی درسته چشمام نمیبینه اما چشم دلم کار میکنه میبینه احساس داره. شاید
شما تا به سینما رفتین؟
سینما با دوستم یکی دو بار منو برده کارهای خودتونم
تصویر براتون توضیح میده؟
بله بله. مثلا اونایی که نمیتونستم درک کنم میگفت که مثلا حالا چی کار کرد اونجایی که صدا نداشت.
بله. چرا میخوای شما بازیگر شی؟
تو سینما یا تئاتر؟
تو بله. سینما. سینما
دوست دارم همیشه یه آدم با احساس، با محبت، همیشه یه جو نقشی مثبت باشه.
مثبت باشه.
بله.
وقت اگر که اون نقش احتیاج به بینایی داشته باشه چی کار میکنه؟ ببخشید من.
خواهش میکنم. اون دیگه بستگی به میل اون کارگردانه. حالا که چطور از ما رو قبول بکنه. حالا نمیخوام تعریف بکنم. ولی اینقدر علاقه داشتم که حتی دو شب تو پارک بودم با دوستم.
کجا بودین؟
تو پارک.
چیکار میکردین؟
به خاطر منتظر بودن و همین لحظه.
دیشب کجا خوابیدی شما؟
تو پارک.
چرا؟
خب چون که جایی نداشتیم.
یه سوال بکنم راستشو میگی؟
بفرمایید.
ببین تو که سینما رو ندیدی با چشم خودت درسته؟ چجوری علاقه داری؟ به صداش علاقه داری؟
احساسش کردم.
چیه؟ سینما رو توضیح بده چیه؟
تو سینما مثلا یه بازی احساسی وجود داره. اونو میتونم بفهمم. طرف داره گریه میکنه به خاطر چی؟ به خاطر مادرش. مرگ مادرش.
میدونم. حالا اگه مثلا ما تو بخوایم که عینکی تو برداری گریه کنی و ببین بلدی بازی کنی یا نه میتونی این کارو بکنی؟
یعنی لازمه.
بله لازمه. عینکت رو بردار.
نمیشه.
عینکت رو بردار لطفا. سرت رو بیار بالا. چشمت رو باز کن.
حتما.
حتما. اگه مگه نگفتی برای سینما همه چی محاضرم بدم؟
بله.
بالا بالا نگاه کن بالا. چشمت رو یه لحظه باز کن. چشمت رو یه لحظه باز کن. باز کن. کاملا باز کن. سرت رو پایین نبر. سرت بالا باشه لطفاً. همونجور سرت رو به من باشه. مستقیم بگی. همینجور که داری حرف میزنی بگو از علاقت به سینما حرف بزن با همون حسی که گفتی دوست داری.
تمام عشقم همینه.
سرت بالا باشه. چشمت باز باشه که ما ببینیم واقعا تو سینما رو ندیدی.
سینما رو دوست دارم. حاضرم به خاطرش همه کاری بکنم.
ببین هر کاری که گفتی سینما بخواد میکنی.
البته اگه راه حق باشه یعنی غیر حق نباشه.
خب مثلا من بخوام که الان چشماتو باز کنی
بله.
باز میکنی برای سینما؟ راستشو بگی به ما که کور نیستی؟
بله.
باز کن ببینم چشماتو. خب چرا دروغ گفتی به ما؟
چون علاقه داشتم.
خب فکر کردی که اگه بگی کوری بیشتر قبول میشی؟
نه، فقط خواستم یه بازی رو کرده باشم، چون شما یه بازی خواستی. پس من گفتم بذار از همون جایی که دارم میام شروع کنم. وگرنه
چرا حالا کور رو انتخاب کردی؟
چون که درکش میکنم.
چرا درک میکنی؟ کسی کور بوده اطرافت؟
نه، ولی هر وقت کوری رو دیدم نهایت سعیمو براش کردم یه کمکش کنم.
خب حالا اگه فکر کنی همین سینما همینه، همین واقعیتی است که تو تصمیم گرفتی بازی کنی و کردی، راضی؟
یعنی دیگه بازی
تموم شد، همین بازی تو بود و تو فیلم هستی.
یعنی تمام بازیم همین باشه؟
همین بوده. اگه الان بخوام که موفق شدی، عینک تو بزن همون جوری برو بیرون، تموم شد، همین بود سینما.
یعنی دیگه نمیتونم بیام تو کار سینما.
چرا؟ ولی این نقش این فیلمت همین بود.
دیگه نقش نیست دیگه. ها
دیگه نقش نیست، چی کار میکنی؟ راضی هستی؟
بله، چون که واقعا از چرا ولی از که اومدم تا اینجا رو
کور اومدی؟
کور اومدم.
کسی نفهمید تو خیابون؟
هیچ کس.
خب اگه همین تست تو فیلمت باشه و همین باشه چی؟
You know, if you haven't seen Salam Cinema, I'll tell you at least about my experience. You see how when people would ask each other, where have you been when 9/11 happened? And everybody remembers and tells stories about how they heard about that. To me, that's how it is with a very few films that I have seen in my life. It's when I see a scene, I go back to that very moment when I first saw this film, because it is so deeply changing. Why I want to show this after what you said, Mohsen, is because 200 rules and
alphabet
and 400 books, maybe 20, and all of this self-learning. Actually, I think that you, on many levels, you invented your own language. So I am kind of resisting your idea about the rules, because I saw how you changed all of them, how you created cinema in a very personal language, how it was never interesting to know what is real and what is fiction, what is documentary and what's fiction. It's a very strong mix of the two always in your work, with a few exceptions which are clearly very much documentary and or clearly very much fiction. But most of your work was always, it was not a question. It was uninteresting to ask, is this real or is it acting? And then it was a lot of you also personally, and this table with the camera and the director sitting is something we see in different films. The kid in silence walking in the market like this is something now we know is very personal. And here it was your homage or tribute to cinema on its 100 years birthday, to the Lumiere brothers, whom you mentioned. So is it true there are rules? You keep destroying them. You keep mixing and crossing lines.
Actually, when I'm telling rules, you can say alphabet. If you have A, B, C, D, and then you will write different article. I made 20 feature film, 5 short film, 5 documentary. I can say none of them is like each other. I don't have a style. I have a style in each film, but I don't have a style as a general, because I don't believe I should repeat myself. But when you have alphabet, you can create your article anytime differently. It is as we learn in private school how we write A, B, C, D. It is not we should repeat A, B, C, D. We mix them, we change them, we put A sometimes at the beginning, sometimes at the ending. But it is alphabet. When you know alphabet, then you can change and you can add your alphabet too. One of the things you mentioned is something comes from my life. It's very important because in experience of life is the good source for your knowledge, because you have in one hand cinema, in one hand your life. If you mix both, you are able to say something that you can only say that. For example, last night the young Vietnamian, I think she is here, she is the only can say about her experience. So cinema plus your experience make you specific. Also, I believe to something else. I say cinema plus, because nowadays in 3 months, we can learn cinema by digital format. It's easier than before. But cinema is tools, has no meaning itself. You need something else, because it's like this microphone. We should have something to tell in this microphone. Where we could find from your experience in your life or other humanistic knowledge like sociology, psychology, literature, philosophy. So when I was in prison, I started to read book. 6 months I was under torture. My left leg completely destroyed. The bone comes out. They took skin from my body to recover that part. But after 6 months, it was good because we had books. Each prisoner could have one book and we share the books. I promise myself to finish one book per day. We were free, we have a little food, so enough time. I read every day one book, but again, concentration. Not one book in sociology, one book in psychology. For example, I started to read psychology. Any book in this matter, I read and finish that. When you take a shower of something very fast, you are able to have sort of overcome to that knowledge. And especially psychology helped me a lot. I couldn't able to make Salam Cinema without that period of learning psychology by book and by observing my friend in prison, how our reaction is the same or different in the same situation. It was like laboratory for me. So I would suggest you cinema plus something. Otherwise, your movie is not, you know, enough deep. Minimum your life plus cinema. Otherwise, you are playing with camera. It's like game for children.
I want to say that you're all invited to raise a hand and say something and join us in this anytime you want. So certainly no need to be shy or anything. We're together here. Yeah, please. Just a second for the microphone and kindly stand up when you speak. Thank you, Laura.
Thank you. Yeah, I would just follow up on your question to be specific about your alphabet. And I mean, it's obvious you break the rules. And I was, because I have this similar experience, I clearly remember where I was and what day it was when I saw Moment of Innocence. Yeah, so I can relate very strongly to what you said. It's just that I also remember what I felt, because, you know, this is not about alphabet or I was thinking when I was trying to explain the film or my sentiment about your film, that, you know, if you watch chess, a chess game, like some games are better than others. You enjoy it more when you understand the rules, all that. When I saw your film, I knew I had seen a three-dimensional chess, which is a totally different game. Yeah. So now I want to know, I don't know if you're where does the third dimension come from?
Actually, the moment of innocence is very specific. I wrote complete script of that movie in an airplane when I was in the Sao Paulo Film Festival in Brazil to Greek. It was like 12 hours flight, and I wrote that script completely. But sometimes I work a lot for one script. For example, the president, few years, my wife and I, we were working that to summarize Arab Spring in one movie. But A Moment of Innocence came suddenly, like poem. I also believe to three things. One is film should be attractive. Otherwise, you don't want to finish that. But how we make film attractive, by, for example, sense of humor, sometimes by fear, different rules. The second is meaning in the film. When you leave cinema, you ask yourself, okay, I waste my time. What I learn? Then the third rule is magic. Without magic, art is not art. And magic related to your subconsciousness. It is not related to the rules. You know the rules, but you let your subconsciousness, you know, cooperate with you. You don't know exactly everything. Especially when you are sleepy, your subconsciousness helps you better at night when you are writing, because you cannot control everything match with the rules. So craziness arrives in the film. In the moment of innocence, you will see reality and something unreal collaborate together to create something that we know and we don't know. For example, when I have a non-professional actor, I don't let them script. They know the script. They don't know a script at all. I say, no, don't know about a script, and know half of the shot. For example, two person is going to act with each other, policeman and his young kid in A Moment of Innocence. They don't know exactly what is the script about. Even they don't know what is this shot exactly about. I tell something in the policeman's ear, secretly, and then I say something to Young, secretly. They know that they should meet each other. They know, I say, okay, answer him when he has a question, but reject his question. But he doesn't know what would be his reaction. So they are acting like improvising. But like I have a kite in my hand. It is collaboration of wind and my hand. It's not completely free. It is not completely prepared. So something comes from me, something comes from them. And if I'm not happy, I change a lot. I change a lot to reach to that level. So I can say we need rules and we need our craziness as well. Otherwise, the art would be like mathematics. But art is not mathematics. Because through of subconsciousness, consciousness, all history of human being comes from your gene out. And you don't know what would happen. Sometimes you will surprise by the sentence that you will write. You say, oh, comes from where? For example, last night, the last sentence of Vietnamian girl, I'm lucky that I'm me, you are lucky that. It is not only by preparing, it is something related to many things. I can say subconsciousness or poem or magic can create this sentence. Other part, I can imagine, okay, she prepared to say this, she act like this, okay. But something is not related to the rules.
Of course, I take note that Moment of Innocence is playing as part of IDFA's focus program called The Villain this year. So you can check out the film in the program of IDFA and go attend it. It's going to be screened in a beautiful copy.
Mention a synopsis of that film. When I was 17 years old, I attacked to police to have his gun. And then police shoot me the bullet comes from my back and comes out from my stomach. And the Iranian people arrest me. Even though I scream against dictatorship, they beat me. They cut my finger by their knife and they gave me to the secret police. Then after like 5 years happened revolution, then 20 years later, I'm filmmaker. I have auditioning. I announced that I want to make a film. The policeman come to me to be my actor. The policeman we fight. In the film is not the main one, but really he came to me. So I asked myself why we don't make film about that concept from two different angles. I will give him a camera, and I have a camera, and we want to see what happened in the past from two different angles. It's a monologue film, not dialogue film. Maybe you say, I told already a story, why we should see that? Because it's not matter of the story, it's matter of the way we made it.
But as you brought up magic, I would like to play a clip from another film, which is Once Upon a Time Cinema. Can I ask you to tell us a few words about the film first? I can do that, but
yes,
so much more interesting.
Yeah, it is a story of censorship in Iranian history of Iranian cinema. There is a king, metaphoric, who censor all the film, and one day he fall in love with one of the actress in one of the movie of history of Iranian cinema. So he changed and he put power aside, and he want to be artist to be able to catch the love. So it is surreal film, but it's about history of Iranian cinema and censorship somehow.
And it is also unique in your filmography because it uses a lot of other people's material.
100 small clip of history of Iranian cinema is like 20 minutes. But like 80 minutes is mine, is like grocery. My film is like the treat, but those are like grocery. It is surreal magic.
You brought up magic.
Yeah.
Can we play the clip, please? و برای سطح تاریخ از سفر پاریس بگویید.
یک شنبه 17 17 تیر سنه 1279 به معیت شما ابرام خان عکاس باشی برای تماشای سینما توراخ لانتر ماش رفتی
ماشی
راستی که اخوان لومیر در اون اتاق تاریک با ما چی کردن؟
کات قبله عالم
این کات یعنی حرف نزن خفه شد زنها چرا در اندرون رو باز نمی کنن؟ فراش باشی؟ ما نبودیم اینجا خبری شده؟
مختصر اخباری هست که عرض خواهد شد
بله
تزار 10 میلیون منات باج میخواست دادیم تا اشهاباد را پس بگیریم ندادند
بله
امرجات طرب و خلوت و خاجگان حرم سرای مبارکه که تا کنون برخت نوکری و لفت و لیس قناعت داشتن مواجب میخواستن ندادیم به گدایی افتادن
از بیکاری چی بهتره
سیقه های درجه سه و زنان از پنجاه گذشته همیشه به نماز ماهی 500 تومان مستمری دیوانی میخواستن ندادیم باب حرم را به روی سلطان مسدود اعلام کردن
دادم یا خب میدادی
از کجا قبله عالم از کجا خزانه ملت از قلب سلطان پاکتر است
عجبا عجبا خیر سرمان میخواستیم برای ملت سینما توغراف تأسیس بکنیم مثلا عکاس باشه هل مفلس فی امان الله فرمول یخت
پس آتیه چه می شود؟ تصدق تن گردن
دده جان شاه بابا جان های دده جان ننم اولی
سلطان قولی را که در سفر مبارک دادن فراموش کردن
ما خودمان جان نداریم بخوابیم آمدیم سر قبر پدرمان
20 سال است قربان 20 سال است آتیه من زیر اشجار بیبرگ در انتظار وصال من است
من تنگال میشم بابا جان
آخر با چه رویی پیش او برگردم
من یتیم گال میشم بابا جان من
جسارت از قربان جسارت است برای من هم فاتحه بخوانی
اگر باجی را ارسال کن تبریز نزد پسر من سینماتوگراف سند کند دادا جان
برو پیش شاه بابا
فرمودید پیش بذارم قبله عالم عجبا من گفتم پیش پسرم نقل رخشوی زن وزیر گمرکات است گفتم سرش نبور شنیدی که ببور
This scene is like history of Iran. Instead of going forward, we go backward. This is coming back. Every day we go one step back.
But we also have the films.
Yeah.
Because, for example, this film, Mohsen, I have no way of categorizing it. It categorizes in the page for films that I cannot categorize. You mentioned 20 clips from 20 films that create the rosary that is this film. And in between it, you construct the story of love of cinema, but also magic, and also censorship, dictatorship, patriarchy, in this piece of work that is not documentary at all, but it's also not fiction. It is like a big dream intercut with history. this was part of the work that you have done. There was this moment in the history of cinema, as my generation knows it, where there was this thing everybody was discussing all the time called Iranian cinema. And it was you, it was the late Abbas Kiarostami, and Amir Nadiri, and a few others. But you were one of the two, three most prominent in that wave that put many small countries around the world in a very interesting motivation, because suddenly it works in a country where there is heavy censorship, where there is so much limitations, but you managed not only to make cinema that the people of Iran were watching, but also to take over the world of cinema and to become a favorite of cinephiles. So I want to ask you now, looking back.
The reason was when 2 years before revolution happened in Iran in 1979, let's say 1975, Iranian cinema was able to make 70 films per year, 70 feature films, and release in cinema. Then Hollywood arrived in Iran. Suddenly Iranian cinema died. Even one film didn't produce. And 2 years later in 79, happened revolution. The extremist people burning cinema, attack to cinema. And after revolution, we didn't have cinema. So we started new wave in cinema. We were under many rules. We couldn't show the sexy scene. We couldn't show first even the action movie. Hollywood was forbidden. It was bad and good because censorship was so high, but in the other side, Hollywood was forbidden. You know, Hollywood is everywhere. Many nations' cinema died by Hollywood. The positive thing in Iranian cinema, we didn't have to compete with Hollywood. So Iranian nation alive again. But we had a lot of limitations. So we find some rules for ourselves. One was reality. We told TV is full of lie and people need reality, truth. So if we make simple subject but real, attract people because they are searching for the truth. Second, we had source of poem, because in Iran we have 30,000 books of poem. So, for example, West cinema comes from first photography, then cinema. Before photography is painting. Painting was forbidden because of religion in Iran. Our cinema has root in our poem. Image comes from our history of our poem. So taste of Iranian cinema was different because we were not repeating Hollywood. Also, we didn't repeat the black artistic movie which were telling loneliness, 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 that they killed us by telling and repeating loneliness in European dark movie. So, okay, go, like Abbas says, go and find a friend. Why you say loneliness? And where is the friend house? You see one child is running to give the notebook of his friend because of his friendship. One day he's running. It was a solution. Really, it is not everything related to the era that we are alone. Something related to ourselves. There is a choice. I can be friend, or I can feel here I am alone. No, we are not alone really. We are together. Cinema is the place that the loneliness ran away. We can see the film in mobile phone. But in cinema, we see the film together, to be framed, to feel we are not alone. So we were not talking about loneliness anymore in our movie. We were talking about friendship and peace in a moment that my country was full of violence. And new wave of Iranian cinema was poetic way of Iranian idea. I think the poem, also the social subject, we were thinking like neorealism in Italy, we inspired by that cinema, the film like Bicycle Thief, because we were talking with each other, we have responsibility for society. The cinema, for me, for example, personally, is love of creation, also responsibility for other people. Okay, we need to do something. For example, nowadays, people are dying because they are fighting with Iranian dictator. In last week, more than 100 people were being killed in the street by police gun, because they scream freedom. I couldn't sit here and say it is not my business, I'm artist. I belong to those people who are dying for freedom. I belong to those people who are poor. As UN says, the still in the, this planet, each night, 15% of human beings sleep hunger. How could I say cinema is art? We should not think about poor people. We should forget about people are in prison, real prison or prison in their country. Again, new capitalism come back, and everywhere control everything. Recently, I made film in South Italy. Really, the system was like 1,000 years ago, censorship, a lot of censorship on my work. They control me. They send police, really. Italian police send to police in something to observe me, how I do. For making one scene, I ran away in some places to make that scene without police observation. We return to bad situation again. So artists are like new modern prophet. We have a meaning. We should fight for our life. Is not fantasy. Yes, magic, but magic is not fantasy. Magic is our craziness. Magic is our poem. Magic is our dream. So documentary is very important, especially because you are searching for the truth. But documentary as a only observation without your point of view is like report. We need your point of view because we need differences. We need different idea. Our differences is our richness. We shouldn't copy each other. We shouldn't copy reality. What is reality? Reality is, in my point of view, is you. But reality in your point of view is me and my friends. So we should share different idea, different point of view to have a perspective of truth. And it is by cinema. Without cinema, we are blind, as you saw on that film. And cinema is eyes of human being nowadays. If you focus on technique, it means you are focusing on glasses of cinema. We need observe and your point of view. So Iranian cinema was this kind of movie. Poetic, social storytelling in a new taste, not Hollywood, not Bollywood, not a European dark artistic movie. And you know, the West talk too much. It was the time that Asian or Middle East have a chance to talk something. For example, Vietnam was victim. We know Vietnam is victim, but Vietnam is part of human being. We want to know their point of view about human being, about this planet. How many film of Vietnam have you seen? Look, it is not only attack of America to Vietnam, attack of Hollywood to the culture. It is 98% of many cinema, you know, had control on the cinema. Still look, Netflix, many other internet or big TV can control our brain. Stupidity comes back by new media. Don't think that internet gave us freedom. It is again in hands of capitalism. That's why independent filmmakers are the only voice of the real human being. These in Netflix, Amazon, blah, 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 is the voice of the new capitalism. So we need you. We need your voice. to find the truth with your point of view independently. Yeah.
You took this like a life commitment, not only you. You took it as a commitment as a family. You and your family took dissidence or this act of refusing to be conformist, to fall into the system. And we know that you created a school at home and that your children did not go to school. So you started as a self-taught filmmaker. You were in prison, but then you carried this and developed it as a family. And this ends now with this family that cinema is lucky to have, because the Makhmalbaf family is always bringing, each of its member is making new films, and there is this very diversified flow from within your family. How can you tell us, what can you tell us about this experience of staying as a family outside of the system? What did you do?
Actually, I was famous in Iran, but we didn't have chance to make more film. For the moment of innocence was banned, I promised to the producer before I making this, if happened censor again, I will sell my home and I will return your money. And then when I finished this film, the government told you should cut this part, cut this part, cut this part. I went to my home and we had a meeting with my wife and three children, what we can do, accept censorship or we sell our house, pay back to the producer money, but we save our freedom and we don't sell our soul. And all of the member of family vote, even Hannah was 8 years old, vote to sell the house. And we sold the house, but we didn't accept censorship on that movie. Okay, and they fall in love with cinema. They feel, oh, what a strong we are. We can leave the home, but take our belief. So Hannah was 8 years old. She ran away from a school and she told, I don't want to go to a school. Before her, my elder daughter Samira was 14 years old. She told that in the school, they teach us ideology, not science. And I become, you know, tired. I told, okay, keep continue if you want to be in cinema. When you reach to 18 years, you can go to the school. And she started to commit suicide. So as a father, I put my hand up and she told me, I want to learn cinema. You learn yourself and I don't want to go and learn from university. I told, okay, start to learn. She told, I don't want to waste my time. Okay, tell me your 200 rules. I want to know that one first. So I share with them. I told, again, to the government, I want to have a small private school. They didn't let me. They told, one problem is like you is enough. We don't need to have more. But we start in our place, the small private school. It was not paying someone. No, it was friendly school. And I invite other people's and other friends' children. Sometimes they were 30, sometimes less. And we had 8 years a school in our home. But what was the style of teaching cinema? It was not like the other university. The one rule was focusing on one thing, minimum 1 month. For example, if you want to learn script writing, only script writing, not 2 hours script writing, 2 hours editing. No, completely 1 month one thing. We had 30 different lessons, but not all of them about cinema. Some of them about life. For example, I told Kurosawa says many people make film with their brain. I make film with my heart. I told I make film with my knee, because if you are not enough energetic, you are not able to handle the process of film. So they start by riding bicycle. And my wife was not able to riding bicycle. I carrying first day, and then Hannah also. We told, when you can ride 50 kilometers, this lesson would finish. After 15 days, even my wife, who was not able to riding bicycle, she was able to riding 50 kilometers. It was the one of the lesson. The second was swimming. Again, you say, why swimming? Because your body needs to, you know, trust to its to herself. So they were 1 month in swimming pool, in the general swimming pool. It was the lesson. When you can swim 1,000 meters, this lesson would finish. And then one lesson was learning the map of capital city of Tehran. You ask why? Because if you don't know your city, how you can make film about your city? Okay, for example, Tehran is big city. There is a one line from south to up, one line from west to east. This, today we learn each street comes to this street till the end. Tomorrow from this part to this. The day after, the parallel line. And then after 1 month, they know where is Tehran. It was my, you know what happened? After 3 months, they saw they can swimming, they can riding bicycle, they know all the city. And it was, you know, self-confidence. We need filmmaker that have self-confidence. If you don't have self-confidence, how you could convince other people? And then 1 month learning poem. Each 3 days focus on one poet. Learning poem, reading poem, thinking if we want to translate to the image of cinema, how would be? You know, learning cinema from poem, not by seeing other movie. If you are from different country, if you read the poem of your country, because the magic comes from your poem, and then you imagine that if I translate to the image, what would be? So it was another lesson which we have. Also, okay, we have editing, we have script writing. Script writing first rule was we have a person who has a goal, there is a problem between him or her and her goal, and there is a force. For example, in bicycle, thief by the Sika, he needs job, but he needs bicycle, someone steal his bicycle, but there is force as well. Why? He insists to reach to his goal because he needs job. Without force, many drama is weak. For example, we were searching for the concept of the force, and force shows us different layer of force on human beings, something like this. And also we learned 2 months psychology, 2 months sociology. I don't know, you have seen the first film of Samira, The Apple, is about a father who put his two daughters 11 years in prison of house when the girl were 2 years till 13 years. Then after 11 years, neighbor understood, informed government to release those children. Samira made film somehow docu fiction on those real people in 11 days. But how she find this subject by the news? But why she understand this is important? Because she learned 2 months sociology, and she knows that if you isolated from society, what would be your attitude as a human being, like animal? So that's why I say cinema plus. We learned 6 different things, 2 months philosophy, 2 months sociology, 2 months psychology, 2 months management, 2 months economy, and 2 months sort of Sufism, is spirituality. Because the concept comes from the human science, doesn't come from cinema. If you learn history of cinema, not concept of history of cinema. For example, you know Lumiere. You know Méliès. It doesn't relate to the meaning of life. It's related to how you use the camera, blah, blah, blah. If you know Koleshov, you know editing, you don't know the, but for example, Tarkovsky is cinema plus philosophy. Bergman is cinema plus philosophy. You need something beside of that. That's why I suggest you, 3 months is enough to learn cinema. But you need something else, experience of your life or another knowledge, but focusing on that. Our school was focusing on 30 different lessons. For example, one of them was learning English language. But again, the rule was 1 month focus, 8 hours per day for one thing, not 2 hours this, 2 hours that, like general school that you learn 2 hours history, 2 hours geography, doesn't work.
Well, at least we know the persons and the films that came out of this school you are telling us about. I want now to talk a little about your relationship with the documentary side of your work. Not only the documentary films you made, because I think there is documentary in every film you made. But to do that, I'm gonna play a scene from the Afghan alphabet.
حالا شما کوزه رو از دوستت بگی دخترم.
نه.
آره شما کوزه رو از دوستت بگی. حالا آفریستا این دوستت صورتشو بشوره. شما حالا صورتتو بشو. چرا نمیشوری؟
چون که نمیخوام جلوی اینا صورتم رو باز کنم.
خب اینا که دوستات هستن.
تو باشن چیه؟ این که بخوار من نیست، برادر خوارم من نیست که بیام صورتم رو پیش اینا باز کنم و بشورم، چون که گناهه.
جایی میشوریم که تنها باشیم، هیچ کس پیشمون نباشه. اگه یه جایی که به صورتمون رو بشوریم کسی مرد یه کسی پیشمون باشه، آدم خجالت میکشه، هم گناه میشه.
چرا؟
ملامت.
چرا گناه میشه؟
چون که وقتی که زنش یه صندوق بزرگ داشته، اما خودش توش نمیرفته، اما زنش توش میذاشته. چون که اگه خوشش میومده میرفته از اون صندوق، در صندوق باز میکرد، بو میکرده، باز میرفته. اصلا نمیذاشته زنش بیاد بیرون.
شما
حاضر
این کارو بکنی؟
آره حاضرم تو صندوق برم، اما صورتم جلوی مرد باز نکنم. زنای افغانستان الان که اونجا جنگ، الان صورتاشون رو پوشوندن. جنگ نیستم صورتشون رو پوشونه، چون که دیگه اگه نامحرم ببینه اون دنیا خیلی بده، آدم عذاب میده، باز آدم عذاب میده. چون که آدم اگه یکی ببینه، باز یکی نبینه، میگه من به صورتم به هیچ کس نشون ندادم. اما خدا میدونه که همش دروغ، صورتش رو نشون داده، اما من نمیخوام اینجا صورتم رو نشون بده. وقتی که تو افغانستان عشقی نباشه، من برم از نونبای نون بگیرم، همون وقتم صورتم رو میشورم. اگه عشق کس نباشه که خدا هست، خدا ما رو میبینه اون دنیا، باز ما رو اون دنیا عذاب میده. نباید صورتتون رو باز کنی. ما وقتی که غم خشای خودمون میاد، اگه اونا رو نشناتیم صورتمون رو باز نمی کنیم. حتی اگه پیش زنا باز کنیم، اما اگه خاله هامون همه همون باشه باز میکنیم، اما روی صورت پیش مردا باز نمی کنیم، چون که خجالت میکشیم. اینا گناهه.
خب دخترم، اگر بخوای توی کلاس بشینی، باید صورتت باز باشه تا قشنگ یاد بگیری درست رو. اگرم دوست نداری برو بیرون. بچه ها صدای آب رو با همدیگه میکشیم. چند تا صدا داشت؟
دو تا.
صدای اولش چی بود؟
آ.
صدای دوم؟
ب.
آفرین. خب
آ.
The subject of the film is something that we have seen a million times. The subject of the film is not what stays with me. I tell you, it's been years since you made this beautiful film. And what stays with me, what made me pick this clip, is the feet of the girl when she is speaking. This movement, this confusion or unrest when she is trying to say that she is scared is what stays. Because religious oppression, I mean, we know, everybody can talk about that. But this is what's not everybody. This is also a question to you. This is also what is the poetical relationship with reality that is sometimes can bypass what you can do in your imagination. You know, like it's very different from trying to imagine what does a girl saying this look like or how can she act. But then when you see her with your camera, you notice these feet and it becomes a totally different poem. It is also a poem, it is not the subject.
I want to tell something before answer to your question. In Iran, we have 3 million Afghan refugees. And 747,000 of them were children without education during Khatami's time, when Khatami was president, during the time that Taliban was in power in Afghanistan. Also in Iran, Afghan children couldn't attend to a school because their parents arrived without visa to our country because they ran away from this, from hunger. And by sudden, I saw many of those children beside of the school observing from the door of a school to the inside of the school with desire to have education one day. So I told I should make this film. For me, this is the best film which I made in my life. I made it in 1 week with handy camera. But I didn't show to the society. I showed to the people of government when the president was better than the others, the Khatami's times. From morning till midnight, I had appointment with the assistant of this minister, assistant of that minister, and I made them cry. And finally, I was able to change a law by this documentary, and the door opened 1 year for 500,000 Afghan children. So it was the best thing which I did in my life. And this is the reason which I say for me, cinema is love of creation, also responsibility for others. Without changing, cinema is not useful. Some people make film to become famous, to achieve awards. Some people make film to find money. Some of us, filmmaking is our job. But for some of us, filmmaking is tools to change the world for something. This is the best film, even though the technically was not strong, one handy camera, very fast. But I observed the tragedy of those people. In terms of the reason why I made that one. But in terms of poem, I believe that if you look at to the reality like movie Gandahar, like documentary, but suddenly you see the legs coming from the sky. I say this art is like tree. The part is on the earth, but a part is on the sky. The documentary is the leg of the tree on the planet. But the poem and magic is the part that is on the sky. That's why many documentary, many film which I made has a documentary side, which is leg, but has something poetic, which is not on leg, is like my imagination. In this film, less. But for example, in Gabbe, which is documentary also, you will see suddenly teacher put his hand on the nature. Imagine that he takes sense of nature and bring to the frame and you will see there is a flower. Or he put his hand point to the sky, when bring back to the face is blue. It's, you know, combination of reality and imagination. Yes, without poem, you know, art is reporting, not it's art. And it is your point of view. That's why I insist that we need to read the poem. Each nation has different point of view to the nature, to the soul, to the spirituality. I don't mean spirituality as a spirituality. Spirituality as a feeling, the sense of soul of human and nature is a poem aspect of the spirituality. So it is in, you will see in Gabbe, for example, you will see in the, let's say, in the movie Gandahar, I don't know you have seen or not, it is about Afghanistan. There is a part that, there is like documentary, 10 minute, people who lost their leg on mine last week, they are talking about their pain, asking a painkiller from doctor. In 10 minute, I stay on their dialogue when they describe their pain. Then they ask artificial leg to walk, and there is no. Suddenly helicopter come and send the artificial legs with umbrella from the sky. And you will see people who has no leg try to compete with each other by stick to take one of those artificial eyes. This moment, after 10 minutes insisting on documentary style, make you ready for some miracle to happen. And then when helicopter come and send the legs down, you feel that the legs is related to the earth coming from the sky. It's surreal, absurd, but it's real also. It is kind of thing.
Please. Please, Laura.
Where's Laura?
Yeah, I could say
here. No, no, we need the microphone. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much for such inspiration. And in Yange Yu, in Innocent Moments, yeah, the character says that my dream to save the humankind, the mankind. Do you still believe in this idea, or yeah, what's the dream for you now?
Still, I'm young. Yeah, you know, when I went to political prison, I was thinking that, okay, life needs meaning. You know, after food, we need meaning. Without meaning, we commit suicide. But what is meaning? If meaning is me again, is selfishness, is not meaning, is emptiness for emptiness. Love of others. So, if I was politician, maybe I do something else. If I am doctor, maybe I save, by surgery I save other people. But when you are artist, you have ability to save human being by talking about their pain and desire. We are tools to, you know, we say, for example, I made my movie in my last movie in South Italy. In the first screening, I brought big mirror in my hand in front of audience. I told, this is cinema is mirror. I want to show you to you. You can broke this mirror, but you can correct yourself as a society. As you all days, morning, you check your face before going out to see if something is wrong or not. Cinema is like mirror. We are mirror maker. Also, is letter from one society to, for example, Syrian can make film about their pain and desire and send this letter to the people of the world to let them understand their situation, to not be silenced, to do something to make their life better. Cinema is sort of meaning. So yes, I wanna, still I am idealist. Without this kind of idealism, you know, we are a part of materialism, and human being is needs both sides. But more wise, not by gun or by attack to police. Yes.
please.
Hello, it's so fascinating listening to you. I feel like I've learned almost as much in this hour as I did in a year at documentary school. But one of the first films that my tutor showed me was Salam Cinema, and I was so fascinated by it at the time. So it's not surprising that this has been so great. But I wondered if you had plans to write a book to contribute to the education of cinema, or if you have written a book, not that I'm looking for a shortcut, but I think it could help quite a lot of people to make films that would change the world.
We need a book from you.
Yeah, actually, I recently had another workshop in London, and I have different workshops. For example, in January, February, I will go to India for 2 months workshop. My workshop is 8 hours per day, 6 days per week, 1 month or 2 months, concentrated on 20, 30 people. For example, I had workshop in Italy, 20 people from around the world, 1 month in the village. And then after that, they made very good film in different country. So if you take a shower, it's better. Book, I don't know book how much is useful. Book needs practice, because I teach one lesson, then we practice for that. Not only reading, because you can read the book which I read. If I add another book, it is 401, it is nothing new. But the way that we practice is more important. For example, the best thing which I gave to my children was self-confidence. Because if you criticize the art of the young student, you will kill them. Even in acting, I have different kind of method to direct actor. One of them is, for example, describing method. There is a documentary which Hannah made. I suggest you show that. It is how Samira made work with non-professional actor. It's educational documentary about acting. If I ask you, okay, who you are in this moment, for example, you don't say we are filmmaker, you say I'm a student now, in this moment. I'm teacher in this moment, not who am I, I'm filmmaker. Who you are in this moment for this shot? Then where are you? Then where you go? Then where you look? Then where you do? Then why? If you mistake, I don't say, no, it was horrible. Because by this, you kill the actor. I say, I perfect. But do you think if we change it to this, what would happen? Giving self-confidence to actor, to filmmaker. That's why careful when you are participating in competition is a little dangerous. Because if you are winner, one person has self-confidence. What about others? Maybe if the jury member are other people, the result would be something else. I had a speech for 300 young filmmakers in South Korea. I told them, look, my mother and my father get married for 6 days. And I remember it was big competition. My father produced 120 million sperm. I was one of them. And it was big competition. All of you, you had big competition and you were winner. This is the only competition that you should win. The order is not important. Don't lose your trust to yourself by losing one award. It's not important. This is to make festival warm, to bring attention. It is like competition in Hollywood movie, but don't believe the competition. Because what is true? Who can say this film is good, the other are rubbish? No, it is 2 days morning, our idea as a member of jury. If you change member of jury, result would change. If you invite this jury next month, the result would be something else. Don't trust to the, award. That's it. You should see how much you enjoy in the process of making film. Don't say, I want to make the best film of my life. You will go for depression. No, try a little better. It is you should try to, your process would be good. Not all the number that you have and from others. And don't have life in others' eyes. You know, have your life for yourself. Don't think if the other doesn't look at you enough good, you feel, oh, I am not an important person. Oh, I'm not useful anymore. This is the dangerous of competition in film festival. I saw many young filmmakers that they couldn't receive award came to me if I was jury and told, you killed me. Because if you gave me this award, I had opportunity to make another film. And I answered them, okay, after that, if another person didn't give you award, they kill you again. And what is the result? You are in a process of depression. Come out. Yeah, we don't make film to be someone. We make film to change something. And process is important. Being with each other is important. Enjoying of the process of film is personal, and results should change something in society. That's why I say Afghan Alphabet was the best film which I made, because it changed the destiny of 500,000 children. But many films of mine receive award. I say, okay, it's famous, but nothing changed by this. Again, I am a speaker.
I'm going to apologize to you and then hope that you will ask your question in the outside, because this was a great ending that I cannot break. Thank you very much, Mr. Makhmalbaf, for being with us. Thank you, everybody, for joining us.
Thank you very much.